हेलो वेलकम एवरी वन, आई एम सुरेंद्र जैन, मास्टर टीचर इन वेदांतु. आई एम डिस्कसिंग मॉक टेस्ट 17 मैथ्स पार्ट. दिस इज क्वेश्चन नंबर वन एंड दिस क्वेश्चन इज ऑफ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. इट सेज इफ वाई इज इक्वल टू वाई एक्स इज द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन विद इनिशियल वैल्यूज एफ ऑफ पाई इज इक्वल टू जीरो और वाई ऑफ पाई इज इक्वल टू जीरो, देन वी हैव टू फाइंड वाई ऑफ पाई बाई टू. ओके, नाउ वी कैन राइट दिस क्वेश्चन क्विकली x dy minus y dx and the remaining thing will be x cube into cos x into dx on the right hand side. If we divide both side by x square, we will get this left hand side to be d of y by x, whereas right hand side will be x cos x dx. So it is now variable separable. Let us integrate it. So we get y upon x on the left hand side. And x cos x, we will integrate it by integration by parts. So first function x, second function cos x. So it will be x sin x plus cos x, I think. Yeah. X sin x plus cos x plus c. And we are given that when x is equal to pi, y is equal to 0. So this will be 0 on the left hand side is equal to minus 1 plus c. So the value of c will be equal to 1. Now they are asking the value of y when x is equal to pi by 2. So y will be equal to pi by 2. We can multiply on the right hand side. Then it will be pi by 2 into sin x, that is 1. Cos pi by 2 is 0 and plus 1. So this will become pi square by 4 plus pi by 2. So that is the answer for this question B. Okay. Yeah, coming to the next question, we are asked find the number of distinct real roots of this determinant equation in the interval minus pi by 4 to pi by 4. I think if we add all the columns, or let me add all of them in the column number 1. So column 1 becomes c1 plus c2 plus c3. Then you can see all the elements of column 1 will have sin x plus 2 cos x. So we can take that common. And first element now will be 1, 1, 1 in the column 1, then cos x, then sin x, then cos x, and then cos x, and sin x. And this is equal to 0. This means either sin x plus cos x will be 0, sin x plus 2 cos x will be 0, and which gives you 10x equal to minus 2. But in this interval from minus pi by 4 to pi by 4, 10 will be ranging from minus 1 to 1. So this solution is not possible. So we will be getting solution from the determinant only. Now we can further use properties in the rows 1 cos x cos x. I will use a property that column 2 will be changed by column 2 minus column. Sorry, row 2 will be changed by row 2 minus row 1. So 0 here. Sin x minus cos x here, then 0 here, 0, 0, and sin x minus cos x here. Actually, I have also used property in row number 3 that R3 will be changed by R3 minus R1. So if you expand it, you will get that sin x minus cos x whole square is equal to 0, which means 10x is equal to 1 because sin x is equal to cos x, so 10x is equal to 1. So in this interval, there is only one possible value where 10x can become equal to 1, that is pi by 4. So answer for this, because number of distinct real values are asked, so answer for this question should be A. Yeah. Now coming to next question number 3. We are given f a to b and g b to c. And ABC is subset of R. ABC are the set subset of all real number such that GOF inverse exists. If GOF inverse exists, means GOF is bijective. And bijective means 1, 1 and onto. Okay. Now there is a property that if GOF is 1, 1, then this F function has to be 1, 1. Otherwise, this cannot be 1, 1. And similarly, if GOF is onto, then G function has to be onto. So in this question, answer should be F is 1, 1, G is on 2. Okay, let me tell you why this property is there. Please understand, if GOF is 1, 1, okay, and F is not 1, 1, then there will be some x1, x2 which are different, but their fx1 and fx2 will be same. Because if f function is not 1, 1, there has to be some x1, x2 which will be different, but their function value will be same. But if that is so, then gofx1 will become equal to gofx2, because fx1, fx2 are same numbers. Okay, and you can see this is equal even if this x1 is not equal to x2, which means that GOF cannot be 1, 1. But if it is 1, 1, that means this is a contradiction, that F is not 1, 1, and hence F has to be 1, 1. Now similarly, to prove it onto what we can do, first we should understand that GOF function will be defined from A to C, because F is from A to B and G is from B to C. And because GOF is onto, so range of GOF function should be equal to C. Okay, and please understand, this G function is giving you the value at fx, and its range is C. Its range is C, which is possible only if that range of G is C. That means G is onto. Okay, G function is from B to C. Please understand, this fx function will give you value from set A into set B, and these values of fx will act as an input for G. Already value of fx lies in the set B, and all these values will act as a domain for G, for which we know the range is C. Hence G function has to be onto, otherwise this GOF will not be onto. So this way we can say this property, how it has come. So C should be the answer for this question. Now coming to question number 4, we are given that first of two samples in a group has 100 items and whose mean is 15 and standard deviation is 3. Standard deviation 3 means variance will be equal to 9. And then there will be, and they are saying if whole group has 250 items with mean 15.6 and standard deviation 13.44. So there is a sample of 250 items and first group is having 150 items. That means the other group will have 150 items. Okay, its mean we do not know, so let us take this as mu 1. Okay, and or maybe mu only. And and for the second group, I think they are asking the standard deviation for second group only. So let us call the standard deviation as sigma. So variance will be equal to sigma square. So we have to find this sigma here. But we are also given that for the entire data of 250, that mean value is 15.6. Standard deviation is 13.44, which means variance will be equal to standard deviation is root over 13.44. So variance will be square of this, that is 13.44. Now, I am going to use one very important property, that if every data is reduced or added by a same number, standard deviation or variance doesn't change. So what I am going to do, I am going to change the each data in sample 1 and sample 2 by 15. Okay, so here also by 15. So by doing this, our variance will not change, standard deviation will not change, but you can see here mean will become 0, here mean will become 0.6 only. Okay, because every data is reduced by 15. So if earlier mean was 15, so now mean will be 0, and in the entire data it will be 0.6, whereas here it will be mu minus 15. Okay, now let us see how we are going to do this question. For new mean, for new mean, please understand this 100 into 0 will be the sum of all the entries of first sample after reducing each value by 15, plus this 150 into mu minus 15 will be the sum of all the entries of the second sample, okay, and it should be equal to 250 into 0.6, that is the sum of all the data, that is 250 in number. So here we will be getting 150 into mu minus 15 is equal to, it becomes, I think, how much, 25 into 6 is 15, 150 actually. So this will be 150 here. So you can see this mu minus 15 comes out to be 1. Okay, now few more calculations we need to do. That what is the formula of variance? I hope that is very important formula everyone should remember. So variance for 100, first 100 entries will be 9 is equal to sigma of square of entries, and I'm calling that as sigma x square, divided by number of entries, that is 100, minus square of mean, that is 0 here. So sum of squares of first 100 entries in that group 1 would be 900. Okay, now variance of the entire data of 250 is 13.44. So it will be equal to sum of squares of data in first entry, first group, and in the second group, which I am calling as sigma y square. In first group, I call this as sigma x square. In the second group, I am calling this as sigma y square. And the total number of entries are 250 here, minus square of mean, which will be 0.6 square. So here we can put sigma x square is equal to 900. Okay, so that will be 900 here. Let me, 900 plus sigma y square upon 250. 0.6 square is 0.36. Let me bring this 0.36 on the left hand side. So here we will get 13.8. Yeah, and let me multiply this by 250 also. So is equal to 900 plus sigma y square. So sigma y square will be equal to this 13.8 into 250. If we do, it will be how much? I think it is equivalent to multiplying by 1000 and dividing by 4. So it will be 4 3s are 12, 1, 4 4s are 16, and then 5. So I think it will be 3450 minus 900. We can multiply by 25 also. So 25 into 8 is 200. 25 into 3 is 75. Plus 20 is 95, and then 25 into 1 plus 9, that is 3450, that's correct. So this will be actually equal to 2550. Okay, now they are asking the mean of second group, the variance and standard deviation actually. So let me first find the variance of second entry, that will be sigma y square upon 150, because number of entries are 150, minus mean of this second group, that is 1 here. So minus 1 square. So sigma y square we have found 2550 upon 150 minus 1, and 15, if we divide this 15, this 255 by 15, it will be 17 minus 1, so it will be 16. So variance, standard deviation should be 4. So the standard deviation should be equal to 4, because root of variance. So answer for this question should be C. Let us see. Yeah, C is the answer. Now coming to question number 5, we have been asked the value of this integral. Very easy question, please understand. This function is odd function. You can check by putting this x minus x in place of x, and you can check it is becoming, after rationalization, negative of log of x plus root over x square plus 1, negative of. So if it is odd function and limit is from minus 1 to 1, so answer has to be 0, nothing else. Nothing else is needed. Coming to question number 6, we are given p is equal to 1, 0, half 1, and we are asked what will be p power 50. Now to do this, to such question, we break this as 1 0 0 1, that is I, and another matrix, that is 0 0 half 0. Okay, so this is I here and this is, let us say, A here. Now regarding this A, if we do square, you can check, it will become first row, first column 0, first row, second column also 0, second row, first column is also 0, second row, second column is also 0. That means A square is nothing but null matrix. And if A square is null matrix, then A cube, which will be A square into A, will also be null matrix. And similarly, all higher powers will also be equal to null matrix only. Now, to find this P, we can use binomial theorem. See, this I, when multiplied with any matrix, it is always commutative. So I into A or I A into I, it is all same. So here binomial theorem can be used. So I plus A raised to the power 50. And if I use binomial theorem, so 50C0 I power 50 plus 50C1 I power 49 into A, and all other elements will have A square, A cube and higher powers of A, which all will become null matrix. So here it will be I power 50, that is I only, plus 51, I power 49 is I only into A. Okay, so if we add these two, we get 1 here, 0 here, I think 51 by 2, it should be 50. It's my mistake, it should be 50, yeah, 50. So here it will be 50 by 2 actually, so 25 and 1 here. So answer for this should be 10251, that is B. Now coming to next question, which says A, B, C distinct positive numbers, if vectors this, this and this are coplanar, then C is equal to. So just make this determinant AAC 1, 0, 1, C, B is equal to 0. Okay, if we subtract row 1, let me first write row 1 and row 2. Okay, then what I'm going to do? I am going to subtract R3 from C upon A times R1. C upon A times R1. So here we will get 0, here you will get 0, and here we will get B minus C square upon A, and that is equal to 0. Now if we expand it along third row, we get B minus C square upon A, and then it will be 0 minus A equal to 0. A cannot be 0, and let me see why A cannot be 0. A, B and C distinct positive number, yeah. A is positive, we are given, so it cannot be 0. So here this C square should be equal to AB. And they are asking what is C equal to. So C will be root over AB, not plus minus, because they all are positive numbers. So answer should be A for this question number 7, yeah. Now coming to question number 8. We are given x be a random variable such that probability function of a distribution is given by, for x is equal to 0 it is half, for x is equal to j it is 1 upon 3 power j. Then mean of distribution and probability that x is positive and even respectively are. Okay, so you know mean means it is a probability of that value of this random variable into that random variable j. Okay, so what will it be, and say summation of this and summation of this. So if we start putting j as 1, so first it is j is equal to 1, then its a probability will be 1 upon 3. If I put j is equal to 2, then its a probability will be 1 upon 3 square. Then j 3, then its probability will be 1 upon 3 cube, and so on and so on. It is going up to infinite. Yeah, it is going up to infinite. So we have to find this summation. I think it's a AGP, isn't it? Because in the numerator 1, 2, 3 and so on. In the denominator we can see 3, 3 square, 3 cube and so on. So we will be writing this as mu, and let us multiply mu by 1 by 3 and displace all the numbers towards right by 1. So 1 into 1 upon 3 square plus 2 into 1 upon 3 cube and so on, and do the subtraction, we get 2 mu by 3, and this will be 1 upon 3 plus 1 upon 3 square plus 1 upon 3 cube and so on, which is infinite GP. So we will get 1 upon 3 in the numerator upon 1 minus 1 upon 3. So I think this will become 1 upon 2, yes, 1 upon 2. So mu becomes 3 upon 4. So this mu becomes 3 upon 4. So answer can be A, B or D. But they are asking the probability that X is positive and even. So this probability that X is even and positive, I think we just have to put J as 2, 4 and so on. So it is just the GP 1 upon 3 square plus 1 upon 3 power 4 and so on up to infinite. So it will be 1 upon 9 here, upon 1 minus 1 upon 9 here, so it will be 1 upon 8. So 3 by 4 as mean and probability being 1 by 8, so answer should be D. Now coming to question number 9, we are given that statement, the match will be played only if weather is good and ground is not wet. Select the correct negation from the following. Please understand, we can assume this match will be played as a statement P. Then the weather is good as Q and ground is not wet as R. So please understand, this statement means P implies Q and R. Because if your game is played, it implies weather is good and ground is not wet. Okay. Now they are asking the negation of this. So please understand, for any if then statement A then B, negation is actually given by A and not B. You can check it by that truth table of A then B. Like if you write A, B, true, true, false, false, true, false, true, false. And if we mark A then B, we know this is true, this is false, and other two are also true, true. And A and not B, if you check, it comes out to be false, true, false, false. It can be checked. A and this T and F will be false. T and T will be true and all other will also be false. So you can see A then B and A and not B, they both are opposite of each other. Okay, so if we want negation of this, that means negation of P, then Q and R, it has to be P and not of Q and R, which means P and inside the bracket, if we bring it, so it will be not Q or not R. So this means match will be played and either weather is not good or ground is wet. So match will be played and weather is not good or ground is wet. So D should be the correct negation of this question. Yeah. Now coming to next question number 10. We are given NPR is equal to NPR plus 1 and NCR is equal to NCR minus 1. So first you please understand, because R cannot be equal to R minus 1. So here this R plus R minus 1 has to be equal to N. R plus R minus 1 has to be equal to N. So that is one equation. And another one is that NPR, whose formula is N factorial upon N minus R factorial, equal to, this will be N factorial upon N minus R minus 1 factorial. So this N factorial will be cancelled in the numerator. So we will be getting N minus R factorial is equal to N minus R minus 1 factorial. Now it's very interesting thing that N minus R and N minus R minus 1 are two consecutive integers and their factorial, how can they be equal? They can be equal only if one of them is 1 and other is 0. Their difference is 1. So this larger should be 1, because 1 factorial and 0 factorial, only they are equal. And rest other, like 1 factorial, 2 factorial, 2 factorial, 3 factorial, they all are different. So here this N minus R has to be equal to 1. That is my equation number 2. Now they are asking the value of R. So let us put this n is equal to 1 plus r from equation number 2 and put it into the 1. So in the equation number 1, we get 2r minus 1 is equal to n, and I am writing this as 1 plus r. So here, this r will be equal to 2. So that should be the answer of this question, that is D. Yeah. Now coming to question number 11, it says, if a tangent to the ellipse x square plus 4y square equal to 4 meet the tangent at the extremities of its major axis at B and C, then the circle with BC as diameter passes through the point. Okay, so we are given this kind of ellipse here, and tangent at the extremities are these, and then we are given that any tangent, we are given that any tangent like this, if it meets the tangent at the extremities of the major axis at B and C, then taking BC as diameter, this circle will pass through the point. Now please understand, there is a property in the ellipse, this circle always passes through the foci of the ellipse. So if I write this ellipse as x square upon 4 plus y square upon 1 is equal to 1, its a is 2, b is 1, so eccentricity will be root over 1 minus 1 upon 4, that is root 3 by 2. So focus will be plus or minus ae, that is root 3 comma 0. So one of the answer here is C for this question. Okay. But if you do not remember this property, please understand how you can do this question. Suppose this point of contact is 2 cos theta comma sine theta. I have taken it in the parametric form. So this line is x is equal to 2 and this line is x is equal to minus 2. So we can write the equation of tangent first at point P, which will be x cos theta upon 2 plus y sine theta upon 1 is equal to 1. So this B point whose x coordinate is 2, if I put it here, we get y coordinate to be 1 minus cos theta upon sine theta. And this is actually 2 comma 1 minus cos theta is 2 sine square theta by 2, and sine theta is 2 sine theta by 2 cos theta by 2. So it will be 2 tan theta by 2. 2 comma 10 theta by 2 here. Similarly, C point has x coordinate minus 2. So here it will be 1 plus cos theta upon sine theta. So this will be 2 comma cot theta by 2 here. So using the diametric form, here it is minus 2. Here it is minus 2. So using the diametric form, we will get x minus 2, x plus 2 plus y minus tan theta by 2 into y minus cot theta by 2 is equal to 0. So this equation will be x square plus y square. There will be no linear term of x, but there will be linear term of y, which is tan theta by 2 plus cot theta by 2 common into y. And here it is minus 4 and here it is plus 1. So minus 3 is equal to 0. Now, if we consider this tan theta by 2 plus cot theta by 2 as lambda, you can see it is actually a family of circle like this, whose common chord would be, whose common chord for any such member of family of circle, the common chord would be y is equal to 0. So if we put y is equal to 0 here, we get x square minus 3 is equal to 0, which gives us x is equal to plus or minus root 3. So you can see the same point is that through which all member of this family of circle will pass through. So answer is C. Yeah. Now coming to next question, that is 12, number of real solution of the equation. Okay. So there is one method that you take this x square as mod x square minus mod x minus 12 is equal to 0. And then you do the factorization and it will be mod x minus 4 one bracket and mod x plus 3 another bracket. Because mod x plus 3 will always be zero, positive, it cannot be 0. So mod x will be equal to 4, which gives us two solutions, either plus 4 or minus 4. They are asking number of real solutions. So answer should be C, that is 2. There is one more way. If you look at this quadratic, you can see product of roots is minus 12. Which is negative. That means For this quadratic, one root will be positive, one root will be negative. Now, because this is a quadratic in mod x, so negative root has no meaning, only positive root will have meaning, and corresponding to that positive root, whatever we get, we are going to have two real solutions. So directly also we could have said that answer will be C. Now coming to question number 13, it says sum of all those terms which are rational number in the expansion. So let us first write the general term of this binomial. So it will be 12 CR, and this will be 2 power 12 minus R by 3 into 3 power R by 4. So that means R by 3, and because you can write this as further 12 CR and 2 power 4 minus R by 3 into 3 power R by 4. So here R by 3 and R by 4 both should be integer. Okay, that means R should be multiple of 12. Then only it is possible. And interesting thing is that the power is 12. So this R can be either 0 when K is 0, or R can be 12 when K is 1. So there will be only two terms when the expansion will have rational term, out of which one will be 12C0, and R will be 0 here. So it will be 2 power 4. That is one term. And there will be last term when R is 12. So 12C12, and 2 power will be 0 here, and 3 power will be 3 here. Yeah, that is correct. 2 power 4 is 16, and 3 power 3 is 27. So their sum is 43. So answer should be D here. Yeah. Now this question, I think mod A given, mod B given, mod of A cross B given, and A dot B, mod of A dot B is asked. Please understand, very easy question. Mod of A square into mod of B square can be written as mod of A dot B square plus mod of A cross B square. Please understand, in the first one, we have mod A, mod B cos theta. And if we do the square here, and similarly here, it will be mod A, mod B sine theta. And if we do the squaring here, you can see mod A square, mod B square will be common, and cos square theta plus sine square theta is 1. Very famous Lagrange's identity for vectors. So here we are given mod A 2, so 4, and mod B 5, so 25 here, is equal to mod of A dot B is asked, plus this is given as 8, so it will be 64. So A dot B square will be equal to 100 minus 64, that is 36. So mod of A dot B will be equal to 6. So answer for this is C. Now coming to next question number 15. The greatest value of the term independent of x in the expansion of. Now please understand, we are having one term which has power of x as 1, and other one is having power of x, that is minus 1. So independent term of x will be lying just in the middle. In fact, we can do it otherwise also. Please see how the general term would be 10 CR and then x sine alpha raised to the power 10 minus R into A cos alpha upon x raised to the power R. So in order this power of x to become 0, 10 minus R minus R to be equal to 0, so R will be equal to 5. So term independent of x will have value of R as 5. So it will be 10C5 into this will be sine raised to the power 5 alpha into A into cos raised to the power 5 alpha. Outside there is A also. Okay. Now they are saying greatest value of the term independent of x in the expansion is this. Then we have to find the value of A. So here we can write this as 10C5 into, if I multiply by 32, so this will become 2 sine alpha cos alpha whole raised to the power 5 into A upon 32. And this is actually given equal to 10 factorial upon 5 factorial square. So you can see this 10C5 itself is equal to this thing. So the entire other thing has to be equal to 1. ओके एंड फॉर दिस टू बिकम मैक्सिमम दिस इज साइन 2 अल्फा इनसाइड द ब्रैकेट सो इट्स मैक्सिमम वैल्यू विल बी 1 ओके एंड हेंस फॉर दिस मैक्सिमम a अपॉन 32 शुड बी इक्वल टू 1 जस्ट वन मिनट आई थिंक a पावर r आई हैव मिस्ड दिस a पावर 5 हियर या सो a पावर 5 विल बी 32 सो a विल बी इक्वल टू 2 सो आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन शुड बी a Now coming to question number 16, they're asking cot of pi by 24, that is cot of 7.5 degree. Pi is 180 degree upon 24, 7.5 degree. Now please understand how this question can be done easily. We can write this as 1 plus cos 15 degree upon sine 15 degree. Okay. 1 plus cos 15 will become 2 cos square 7.5 upon 2 sine 7.5 cos 7.5. So it will become cot 7.5 degree. Now in this we will be using value of cos 15 degree which can be found using cos of 45 degree minus 30 or 60 minus 45. Same thing. So in the numerator it will be 1 plus, please understand, root 3 plus 1 upon 2 root 2. For cos 15 and for sine 15 it will be root 3 minus 1 upon 2 root 2. If we multiply in numerator and denominator by 2 root 2 we get 2 root 2 plus root 3 plus 1 here and root 3 minus 1 here. Now to rationalize it we will multiply denominator by root 3 plus 1 and also in the numerator. So this denominator will become 2 only whereas here we will be getting 2 root 6, okay, plus 2 root 2, plus 3, plus root 3, plus root 3, plus 1. So we can see it becomes root 6. 2 root 2 by 2 is root 2 only. Root 3 plus root 3, 2 root 3 by 2 is root 3 here. And 3 plus 1, 4 by 2 is 2 only. So you can see it becomes root 6 plus root 2 plus root 3 plus 2, so answer is D. In fact, this is one question which we do in class also. Okay, so one may remember this result and this question was just one second question. Now, question number 17. Fx is given as 0 to x, 5 plus mod of 1 minus t dt, x greater than 2 and 5x plus 1 for x less than or equal to 2. Now x is not differentiable, continuous, okay. So let us try to find for x greater than 2 what will be this integral. So I can break this integral into two parts, 0 to 2 and because x is greater than 2 so we can write this as 2 to x and this will also be a positive interval. We don't have to go back. I think x is greater than 2 so it will be both of the interval will have actually a geometrical meaning on the graph also. So 0 to 2, it will be 5 plus and please understand because t will be varying from 0 to x, 0 to 2 here. Okay. So I think I cannot break it into two part. I cannot break it in single go. I have to make two cases. So first let me write this as mod only. Okay. And for 2 to x, please understand this will be 5 plus and because t is greater than 2, so here it can be written as t minus 1 dt. So what I was telling you there, let me repeat it here. Let me break this once again from 0 to 1. Then here it will be 5 plus 1 minus t only because t is less than 1 for this particular interval. Then when going from 1 to 2, this 1 minus t mod will become t minus 1. dt and this will be 2 to x, this is t plus 4 dt, here it is dt. So this integral will be 6 minus t, so 6t minus t square by 2, 0 to 1 plus this is t plus 4 and integration will be t square by 2 plus 4t from 1 to 2 plus it is t square by 2 plus 4t and here it is 2 to x. Okay, actually we have to check continuity also. So we have to put x is equal to 2 here, and to do this, let us first calculate this completely. So here it will be 6 minus half, so 5.5 here from this first limit, whereas the second limit will give you 2 square 4, 4 minus 1, so 3 by 2 here, plus 2 minus 1, 1, so 4 here, plus x square by 2, plus 4x, okay, and putting lower limit, it will give us 2 and 8 here. So this will be 4 plus 1.5 is 5.5, so 11 here. So this gives us x square by 2 plus 4x and plus 1, because minus 10 here, 11 here. Okay, now if we see what is the value at x is equal to 2 here, at x is equal to 2, if you check, it becomes 2 plus 8, 10, 10 plus 1, 11. Whereas for x less than or equal to 2 also, we are getting same 11. So that means it is continuous function. Now to check the differentiability, we can do the differentiation. For first place, we can do the differentiation of this also, because we have done the entire calculation. So we can do this way also. So here it will be x plus 4, whereas for this other part, it will be 5 only. So for x greater than 2, you can see this limit will become 6. Whereas for x less than or equal to 2, it is 5. So it is not differentiable at x is equal to 2, but it is continuous at x is equal to 2. So answer for this should be equal to b only. Now coming to question number 18, it asks that lowest integer which is greater than 1 plus 1 upon 10 power 100 raised to the power 10 power 100. So you can see 10 power 100 is a huge number. And we can think of this as 1 raised to the power infinity in determinant form. Okay, and this will be h, or very small function, and same function here also. So if we just find the limit of this, I think it will be e power 1 upon 10 power 100 into 10 power 100. So it will become e power 1 only. Okay, so because e is less than 3, greater than 2, so answer for that has to be a. In that sense, we can do it directly, but let us see how this question can be done otherwise also. Please see, if we open it by binomial theorem, it will become, let me write this as 1 plus 1 upon capital N whole raised to the power capital N. Okay, so this will be NC0, that is 1 only, the next term would be capital N into 1 upon N, then it will be n into n minus 1 upon 2 factorial into 1 upon n square plus n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 upon 3 factorial into 1 upon n cube, and so on. Okay, so here you can see the very first two terms are having their sum to be equal to 2. Okay, and then if you see, I can write the next term as 1 upon 2 factorial into, and this would be 1 into 1 minus 1 upon n plus 1 upon 3 factorial, then it would be 1 into 1 minus 1 upon n, then 1 minus 2 upon n, and so on and so on. So it is very much obvious that it is going to be greater than 2. Okay, now if we take these terms 1 minus 1 upon n, 1 minus 2 upon n as 1, okay, then we can see this thing will be less than 2 plus 1 upon 2 factorial plus 1 upon 3 factorial, and so on and so on. Even though there will be finite number of terms, because this number is 10 power 100, so number of terms will be finite, but if we consider this to be infinite, then you can see this 1 upon 2 factorial plus 1 upon 3 factorial and so on and so on, it is actually e, because expansion of e is what, 1 plus 1 upon 1 factorial plus 1 upon 2 factorial and so on and so on. So initial two terms are not there, so 1 upon 2 factorial plus 1 upon 3 factorial, they all will be actually e minus 2. So you can see that this term, this expression given to us in the question, will be lesser than e. And because e is less than 3, so this number has to be less than 3 as well. and it is already greater than 2. So this number is lying between 2 and 3. So the lowest integer that is greater than this is has to be a only, that is 3. Now coming to question number 19, it says this denotes greatest integer less than or equal to x, then this is equal to, okay, we are given n is equal to 8 to 100, okay. And please understand, whenever n is even number, so number inside it would be integer, so we can remove this greatest integer sign. So like if I put n is equal to 8, this minus 1 power 8 will be positive, non positive 1. So here it will be 8 by 2, that is 4. Then next, when we put n is equal to 10, it will be 10 by 2, that is 5. Then we put 12, so it will be 6, and so on. If we put 100, it will be 50, and they all will be added, because minus 1 power even will be plus 1. And then if we put n is equal to 9, you can see it will become minus 9 by 2, greatest integer of minus 9 by 2. Then 11, if we put, it will be minus 11 by 2 jint, and so on. And in the end, if we put n is equal to 99, it will be minus 99 by 2. Okay. So here we cannot, this jint is not required. I think we can write simple bracket. So here it is 4 plus 5 up to 50. How much will it be? There are how many terms? Or let me do one thing. Let me write the other value of greatest integer brackets also, because some terms will be subtracted from here. So minus of 9 by 2, the greatest integer would be minus 5. For minus 11 by 2, it will be minus 6, and so on. You can check for minus 13 by 2, it will be minus 7, and in the end it will be minus 50. So it has now become very easy that this terms from 5 up to 50, they will be cancelled, and we will be left with only 4. So answer for this question has to be B, that is 4. Yeah. Now coming to next question, that is 20. Let equation of pair of lines y is equal to px and y is equal to qx can be written as their product after writing this px and qx on the left hand side. Then equation of pair of angle bisector of the lines is, see, for this pair of straight line ax square plus 2hxy plus by square, there is a direct formula for pair of angle bisector, which is given by x square minus y square upon a minus b is equal to xy upon h. So we will use that directly, and we will get here as x square minus y square upon a minus b, that is 6 here, is equal to xy upon minus 2 here. So this minus 2 will cancel this minus 3 times. So we get x square minus y square is equal to minus 3xy. If I bring this 3x by this side, so it will be x square plus 3xy minus y square. So answer for this question should be B. Yeah. Now coming to question number 21, which is first integer type question. We are given a plus b plus c as 1, ab plus bc plus ca as 2, abc as 3. And we are asked what will be a power 4 plus b power 4 plus c power 4. Now to do this question, one of the method can be that we form a cubic whose roots are a, b, c. So if this cubic will be x cube minus sum of roots into x square plus sum of product taken two at a time into x minus 3 is equal to 0. Okay, now because a, b, c satisfies it, so it will be a cube minus a square plus 2a minus 3 is equal to 0. Similarly, b cube minus b square plus 2b minus 3 is equal to 0. C cube minus c square plus 2c minus 3 is equal to 0. If I add all of them, you can see we can find sigma a cube minus sigma a square plus 2 times sigma a plus b plus c, which is 1 only, minus 9 is equal to 0. Now the sigma a square can be directly found by this a plus b plus c whole square minus 2 times this ab plus bc plus ca. So this will be 1 minus 4, that is minus 3. So that means root has to be imaginary. So here you can find sigma a cube from this relation. We will be having sigma a square that side, and plus 7 here. 2 minus 9, minus 7, that's why it will be plus. And because sigma a square is minus 3, so it will be 4 here. Now, what I am going to do, I am going to multiply these three equations by a, b and c, and then I will add them. So we will be getting now sigma a power 4 minus sigma a cube plus 2 times sigma a square minus 3 times a plus b plus c. Okay, and I will make use of the sigma a cube here. So this will give us the answer of sigma a power 4. Here it is minus 4 and this will be minus 6 because it was minus 3 into 2 is minus 6 and minus 3 here. And this is equal to 0. So the sigma a power 4 will be 13. So answer for this question should be 13. Okay. Coming to next question. This says consider the function fx is equal to px upon sin x minus 2 for x not equal to 2, 7 for x is equal to 2. Where px is a polynomial and p double dash is a constant, which means px is a quadratic. Because then only its second derivative can be always constant. And we are given p3 as 9. Okay. And we have to, we are given that fx is a continuous function at x is equal to 2, then we have to find p of 5. Now please understand, because fx is continuous, so the limit of this function should exist at x is equal to 2. In fact, for this function, limit x approaches to 2, px upon sine of x minus 2 has to be equal to 7. Okay, because px is a quadratic and in the denominator it is becoming 0. So this px should also have a factor of x minus 2. Okay, so we can write this as k times x minus 2 and another factor as x minus alpha. So here it will become k into x minus 2 into x minus alpha upon sine of x minus 2. Now please see, this x minus 2 upon this can become equal to 1. This is become equal to 1. So you can see this k times 2 minus alpha has to be equal to 7. So this is one of the equation we are obtaining. Now we are also given that p3 is 9. So p3 means it will be k into 3 minus 2 is 1 and 3 minus alpha, and this will be equal to 9 here. So here we are getting k into 3 minus alpha is equal to 9. So two equation, two unknown we can find here. And let me check what we are looking for. We are looking for p5, which will be 3 into k into 5 minus alpha. Okay, so to find here k and alpha, we can divide it. So we get 2 minus alpha upon 3 minus alpha is equal to 7 by 9. So this gives us 18 minus 9 alpha is equal to 21 minus 7 alpha. So this gives us 2 alpha is equal to, I think, minus 3. Yeah, minus 3. So alpha will be minus 1.5. If I use this, we will be getting k is equal to 7 upon 3.5, that is, I think, 2 here. Yeah, k is 2, alpha is 1.5. So this p5 will become equal to 3 into 2, 6 into 5 plus 1.5, that is 6.5. So 13 into 3, that is 39. So answer for this question number 22 should be 39 here. Now coming to question number 23, it says a rectangle is inscribed in an equilateral triangle of side length 2.20, side length 2 root 2 as shown in the figure. Then square of largest area of such a rectangle is, okay. So let us take its one side as A and other side as B. Okay, this angle will be 60 degree. So because this is B, so this will become B upon root 3. By 1060, you can see B upon this side. So this side will be B upon root 3. And by symmetry or otherwise also we can say this will be B upon root 3. Okay, so here this is A, so here this will also be A from this point to this point. So this length of this side, which is A plus 2B upon root 3, will become equal to 2 root 2. And area of this rectangle is A into B. So we can write a in terms of b, which will be 2 root 2 minus 2b upon root 3 into b here. Okay, so this has become 2 root 2b minus 2b square upon root 3. So it's a downward parabola. It's the minimum, its maximum value, which we are looking for, largest area, its maximum value will happen at that minus b upon 2. We know that thing, what is minus b? Minus b means it is 2 root 2 here upon 2a. A is minus 2 upon root 3. So the maximum value will occur at, we can cancel this 2 with this 2, and minus minus plus, this will be root 6 upon 2. Let me check once again. Yeah, root 6 upon 2. Okay, so this a max will occur when b is equal to this thing, root 6 upon 2. So 2 root 2 into root 6 upon 2. In fact, this maximum value is minus d upon 4a. So we can make use of that also, but we may use that also. Same thing, I think answer will be same. No change should be there in the answer. 2 upon root 3, and b square is how much? B square is 6 upon 4. So this becomes here, 2 will get cancelled, and this will be root 12 minus 3 upon root 3, that is root 3 here. So this 12, root 12 is 2 root 3. So this answer is root 3 here. So the square they are asking, actually, square of the largest area of such rectangle, answer will be 3. Let us see what is the answer. Yeah, answer is 3. In fact, after this step, we could have done it by differentiation with respect to b also. That is also the same thing here. We will get same answer. Now coming to question number 24, it says, let a curve y is equal to fx pass through this point, have slope 2y upon x log x for all positive real values of x, then what is the value of f of e? So this question is actually that dy upon dx is equal to 2y upon x ln x. So here it will become dy upon y is equal to 2dx upon x into ln x. So if I integrate it both side, so it will become ln y, and on the right hand side it will be 2 ln of ln x. We can take ln x as t, and you can see it is dt upon t, so integral will be ln t. That means 2, that means ln of ln x, and 2 is constant multiplied with this plus some constant, or let me take this constant also as log ln of k. So here it will become y is equal to ln x whole square into k. Okay, and we are given that at x is equal to 2, this y is equal to ln of 2 whole square. So let us put that way. So y is ln 2 square is equal to k into ln 2 whole square. So k becomes equal to 1. Now they are asking what will be the value when x is equal to e. So y of e will be 1 into ln of e whole square. That means it will be 1. Ln e is 1. So answer should be 1 for this question. Yeah. Now coming to question number 25, it says fair coin is tossed n times such that probability of getting at least one head is at least 0.9. Okay. Then minimum value of n is, please understand, probability of getting at least one head means 1 minus probability of no head. Okay, at least one head means 1 minus probability of no head. And probability of no head means it has to be tail all the time. So it should be 1 by 2 power n, because probability of tail every time is half, half, half. So 1 by 2 power n. And we want this should be at least 0.9, means greater than or equal to 0.9. So we get 1 upon 2 power n to be lesser than or equal to 0.1, or I can say 2 power n to be greater than or equal to 10. So this n will be greater than or equal to 4. 2 power 3 is 8, which is not satisfying it. 2 power 4 is 16, it is satisfying it. So answer for this has to be 4. Yeah. Now coming to question number 26, it says equation of a circle is given by real of z square plus 2 times imaginary part of z square plus 2 times real of z, where z is x plus iota y. So please understand, if z is x plus iota y, then z square will be x square minus y square plus iota into 2xy. So this question here has become, real part will be x square minus y square plus 2 times imaginary of z square means y, so 2y square plus 2 times real of z means it will be 2x is equal to 0. So we are getting this as the equation of the circle, x square plus y square plus 2x is equal to 0. Now question is, the equation of circle is this, a line which passes through the center of the given circle, center is actually minus 1 comma 0 and the vertex of the parabola. Okay, so parabola, if I make the complete square, it is x minus 3 square here is equal to y minus 13 plus 9. You can check, I have added 9 here, so I have to add 9 that side also. So x minus 3 whole square is equal to y minus 4. So vertex of this parabola will be 3 comma 4. So they are asking the line passing through the center of the circle and vertex of the parabola has y intercept equal to, okay. So these are the two points. So I can write the equation as y minus 0 is equal to 0 minus 4 upon minus 1 minus 3 into x plus 1. So here it will be 4 upon minus 4 upon 4. So let me write this as 1 only. Yeah. So x plus 1. So the equation of line is coming out to be x plus 1 and we are looking for y intercept. Y intercept means x has to be 0. So y will be equal to 1. So answer for this question has to be 1. Yeah. Now coming to question number 27. It says let n belongs to capital N, that is natural number, and this bracket denotes greatest integer, then sum of n plus 1 terms of this is equal to 2 power 100 into 101, then what is the value of 2 times jint of n minus 1 upon 2. Now this sum is actually equal to summation of, here you can see nc0 is multiplied with 1, then nc1 is multiplied with 3, then 5. So here you can write this as 2r plus 1 multiplied with ncr. R is equal to 0 to n. Okay. Now if we remember the formulas, then this question is very simple. We can write this as 2 into r into ncr plus summation ncr. R is equal to 0 to n and this is r is equal to 0 to n. So here it will become 2 times and the formula for this is n into 2 power n minus 1 and the formula for this is 2 power n. Okay, so this becomes actually equal to 2 will be multiplied with 2 power n minus 1. So power will become 2 power n only. So 2 power n common and we get n plus 1. And this is given to us as 2 power 100 into 101. So you can see this gives us n is equal to 100. Okay, so answer for this should be 100 minus 199 upon 2. Its jint will be 49. 49 into 2, it should be 98. Let us see what is the answer given here. Yeah, 98. Now you can do this question otherwise also by writing this series in two order, starting from beginning to end and then reverse the order. So last term will come in the starting and second last term will come on the second term and so on. Then add both of them. Then also you can do this question. Actually, this method we use to derive the formula for sigma r into ncr also. But it should be remembered. That's a very standard result. Coming to question number 28, it says, if the lines x minus k upon 1 and so on, and this are coplanar. Okay. So for coplanar, please understand there is a direct result that we write a determinant whose first row is the difference of points lying on these two lines. And points are k, 2, 3 on the first line, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 in the second line. So the first row will be k plus 1, 2 plus 2, so 4, 3 plus 3, so 6. Second row would be the direction ratios 1, 2, 3 here and 3, 2, 1 here. So this we have to make equal to 0 and that's it. We may use some property here. I think 2 2's are 4, 3 2's are 6. I think only one property is needed, that R1, if we subtract it by 2 times r2, I think we can make 2 zeros. K plus 1 minus 2, it will be k minus 1. 0 here, 0 here. 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1 is equal to 0. So we are getting k minus 1 into 2 minus 6 is equal to 0. So the value of k has to be 1 only. So many questions are having same answer 1, I think, in this paper. Now coming to question number 29, which says a plus 3b is perpendicular to this and a minus 4b is perpendicular to this. Then the angle between a and b is, okay, in degrees they are asking. So this a plus 3b, its dot with 7a minus 5b should be equal to 0. So it will become 7a square. I am not, or let me write bracket symbol also, but it was understood actually that it is vector 7a square minus 15b square. And if you multiply a with b, so 21 here and minus 5, so plus 16a dot b will become equal to 0 from our first condition. Similarly, this a minus 4b dot product with 7a minus 2b, it will be equal to 0. So here it will become 7a square once again plus 8b square and minus 28 minus 2, so 30 minus 28 minus 2, so minus 30 a dot b will be equal to 0. Okay, let me write it here. 7a square plus 8b square minus 30 a dot b is equal to 0. Okay, so what we can do, we can subtract second equation from the first. We will get minus 23b square and it will be plus here 16 plus 30, I think it is 46 a dot b, yeah, a dot b, and this will be equal to 0. So you can see that a dot b is coming out to be equal to b square upon 2. Okay, now if we put this a dot b here, or yeah, if I put a dot b here in the equation number 1 or in the equation number 2, same thing. So we will get 7a square minus 15b square and it will become plus 8b square is equal to 0. So 7a square minus 7b square is equal to 0. So this a square becomes equal to b square, or mod a is equal to mod b. Yeah, now I think the question is done. Let me do the calculation. Here, cos theta, the angle between a and b can be calculated using cos theta equal to a dot b upon mod a mod b. A dot b is b square by 2. Mod a mod b, they are equal. So I can write this as mod b square. This b square is actually mod b square only. I hope you all would have understood it already. This is mod b square only because b square means b dot b, which is mod b square. So here we get this to be equal to 1 by 2. So cos theta is 1 by 2. So theta has to be equal to 60 degree in degrees. So answer should be 60 of this question. Coming to last question, it says the coefficient of x power 7 and x power 8 in the expansion are equal. Okay, then the value of n is. So please understand, coefficient of x power 7 will come in that term in which n c 7 2 power n minus 7 into x by 3 whole power 7 is taken, and x power 8 will come in that term in which n c 8 2 power n minus 8 into x upon 3 whole power 8 is taken. Because coefficient of x power 7 and x power 8 are equal, this means n c 7 into 2 power n minus 7 upon 3 power 7, it will be equal to NC8 into 2 power n minus 8 upon 3 power 8. So this I can cancel 3 times. 2 power n minus 8 will cancel it 2 times. Okay. So this NC7 upon NC8 will be equal to 1 upon 6. Yeah, 1 upon 6. So n factorial upon, this will be 7 factorial, n minus 7 factorial, whole divided by n factorial upon 8 factorial n minus 8 factorial, and this is equal to 1 upon 6. So this n factorial will be cancelled. 7 factorial will cancel 8 factorial 8 times. N minus 8 factorial will cancel n minus 7 factorial n minus 7 times. So after all simplification, we get 8 upon n minus 7 is equal to 1 upon 6. So n minus 7 comes out to be 48. So n will be equal to 55. So answer for this question should be 55. Yeah. So this completes the solutioning of this paper. Thank you so much. Bye everyone.